Hi everyone, feel very welcome to Usitility. Today we are on the way to see how to launch and play Craftsman on your PC. As you can see, you are watching it on screen. We will be able to effortlessly download and set up Craftsman and enjoy the game on a Windows desktop or laptop with keyboard, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's go buddies! Before anything else mates, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type this URL, because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed below on our Usitility site, where we have a comprehensive description on just how to download Craftsman on computer. We scroll down a little bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on the link, we land here on the website of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Craftsman on the PC. As you can see here, we get a number of advantages of running that emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we will proceed to download the Craftsman by clicking on this button, Download Craftsman on PC, that I have marked in green color. We then click on it. Of course, the download action starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the installer. Okay, then we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the browser to view the installer better. The installation software is very easy to use. It includes two possibilities: install and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path truly does. We purely click it, and therefore we observe that we have now here the path in which the emulator can be installed. If we plan to vary this folder, we have to click on this browse button, and we select another directory and set up the emulator wherever we want. To keep it simple, just keep it where it is. I click on back. Therefore I simply click on install. At this time, before beginning installing the emulator, will also be possible that it will suggest us more than one application deals to set up on our PC. As I do not desire any of those computer software, I simply click many times on the reject option. Fantastic. The installation begins and it will go forward with the download of all these MB that happens to be shown on that screen. When you save it on your hard disk, it could be slightly more or less megabytes. The download speed may go faster or at a lower speed, depending on your connection and according to the speed of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they're going extremely fast. The download has been successful, and so at this time it proceeds with the setup phase. The setup is going to take a little bit more or less time according to the power of your personal computer. The more powerful it really is, the shorter the software setup time and or vice versa. If we combine the download and installation step, it normally takes quite a long time, so have patience. It is already completely finished on my side. At present, the emulator has been launched automatically. As you can discover, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up, and when it gets into the finish, the emulator can be launched for the very first time. Indeed, the emulator was already launched, here it is for the very first time. And as a result, LD Store is immediately launched, which is a sort of Google Play. This isn't the best technique to set up the game, so I don't recommend it, since in some cases the LD Store puts an obsolete version of the game. I will reveal to you the right way to install the video game by utilizing the Google Play, and I recommend you to do it this way. The initial thing we are required to accomplish is to go to the computer's desktop by clicking on this software icon that I'm indicating in green. Before we keep going, as you can observe, it made two app icons here on the computer desktop: the LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer software icon will be one we are considering. Whenever we choose to operate Craftsman on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this particular app icon and start the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything such as that. The reality is, it's an app icon that we may almost certainly never make use of. Shall we perform the following step, which is a must-have, and that is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. To execute this, we will browse here to System Apps, we click. And we are going to simply click on Play Store. As you can view, the Google Play is launched. Right here we have to log on. So now as soon as we are here, we must absolutely do this following step that is definitely compulsory. Therefore we simply click on Sign In. Presently it says, Checking Info. It may sometimes get stopped at checking info, and it isn't going to advance. In this case, you could try to log in after a number of hours and it will very likely be solved. At this time we will insert our email and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its related password. For instance, you may use the same email you are using currently in your YouTube account. So I am going to provide my details and I will return immediately after I have done it. Voila! Details inserted. Here is Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We should consent to all of them simply by hitting, I agree. Following that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked, it's going to build a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you can make use of that option if you want. We mouse click on accept. By now Google Play is launched by default and automatically. In case that the Google Play is not presented instantly and you have no clue how to run it by hand, I explain to you how to do it. The very first thing is to head to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this app icon marked in green. Straight away we go to the system apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Yes, we're there inside Google Play. What we intend to do right now is browse here to search for apps and games. And we're going to do a search for Craftsman. There we have got it, we will choose the very first result. Listed here we get the video game. So let's then click here on the install link that I am just showing now in green. That click will begin the setup. At this moment it is going to download and install the game app. It normally takes a little while or it might possibly be very fast. This all relies upon on our own connection to the internet. It has already completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by hitting this particular button I'm highlighting in green, that allows you to start Craftsman for the very first time. You are by then on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to simply click on the brand new Craftsman software icon which has been generated. Your video game is launched for the first time. Here we have it, I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the volume level of the emulator. This is here, we use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the max, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is the first one, we click on that icon which I am showing in green. Thus the screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. Granted that we really want to have fun with the game using all the screen, we select that game icon. And we'd at present be enjoying the gameplay in full screen function. To quit the complete screen setting, push the F11 key. And we might at present be in standard screen setting. At present, I am starting to demonstrate to you the keyboard mapping and that is rather helpful. That means we may be capable to use the video game much more effortlessly. The very first thing is to click on this computer keyboard icon. And at this time there you will be able to get the necessary setups. I will put the standard settings, however if you wish to modify it, you can also achieve it without having problem. I grab this chance to comment that sometimes, when launching the game a dark screen comes out, if it is so and you notice the black screen and the emulator doesn't begin, I suggest a doable solution. We can browse here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator options, in the advanced choice we have a large number of resolutions. The following is the pixel quality we've at the moment picked as favorite choice and we should select any of these other screen resolutions, for example this one below. We take it and after that click save. It will probably ask us to reboot that emulator and soon after restarted, most likely the emulator will commence and the black screen will vanish. Clearly, the emulator is totally in our language. Sometimes it occurs that the emulator is presented in the improper language, for instance, in Chinese language. And as a consequence to set it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus here inside of other configuration settings, we click on the language drop down. We may very well select the language we wish, Spanish, Japanese, and so on. Once the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will restart, and the game, the next time we use it, would as well be in the specified language. So now, there's another element that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will get a message from Google Mail reporting that a brand new machine has been linked to our Google account. It is going to ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Of course, we may not worry, as the emulator is behaving like an Android tablet or smartphone. So you can discover which electronic device is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Let's go here to the model choice. And here we learn that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it, folks, so much for that tutorial. I hope that you liked it, specifically that everyone thought it was handy. In that case, offer it a good like, subscribe to the channel, and if you have remarks, questions or suggestions, let them in the comment area below. You could also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams occasionally, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of these online videos which are usually appearing on the screen, and let's have fun again in the future instructional videos. Bye.